好的。Bro, I think I'm only enjoying P5 leads, bro. I'm only in one P4 lead, bro. You hear me? I'm only in one P4 lead. This bitch got DK Metcalf? How the fuck he got DK? Bro, how the fuck he got DK Metcalf? Yeah, I think I'm honest. I'm just doing a bunch of down shit. Yeah, bro. I told you already. Can you see my waves in the back?
Oh my god, you in these damn waves already.
Oh, good job. Pull the fuck on home.
Stop being here. Stop being here. DJ Rear. Bro, what the heck wrong with this commissioner, dog? Let's have Mari real quick, say Mari. This dude's... What about DJ Rear? Oh, hell no. Actually... Oh, hell no. I'm taking a $20 penny. Actually, I don't need a cornerback, bro. I got two. I need another cornerback for Wayne. I'm gonna start. I got 6'2 cornerback, bro. 92 speed. Bro, for real.
That's the best way. That's the best way to stream. Twitch.
Yo, who did a group FaceTime today?
I don't know why.
Oh, never mind.
What happened?
No, it said Tommy. I forgot. I said my store manager. I don't know why they did a group. I wasn't gonna join it.
Why? I was your store manager, you were joining, huh? Who? Who's on me?
The baby, this part of his stuff is fun.
The cute one?
Yeah.
You know what makes it funny?
Huh?
You know what makes it funny?
You wanna make some money.
You know what makes it so funny?
What?
That's what you call a name.
Who?
Harmony, that's Ari's middle name.
Middle name?
Yeah, Harmony. Mm-hmm. I can't send that. This is an ugly motherfucker you can dress to. Homeboy main, bro. I didn't see his boy in a minute.
Her name is
Ari Harmony Bowling.
Duh!
That's your ass, bro.
No, you are. Like, I don't know who her last name is.
My prayer was bulging. It could be Mitchell.
What?
It could be Mitchell.
Well, you would have been the dummy to make another one and made your second one he made after you.
What the fuck, George?
He came in hot. He anticipated your long arm blocking and he scooped it on the underneath and dumped it in the basket. You saw it coming. He came in hot and then he came on the underneath. Hey, grab him and hold him. Grab him and hold him. You didn't grab him and hold him. The whole team was there. Y'all couldn't grab him and hold him. Get on the bus. Oh, he's coming in. He's coming in hot. Grab him and hold him. You didn't make the adjustments. He made the adjustments mid-air. Nobody grabbed him. Nobody held him. Let him fool you on the outside. He's coming in. He's got his eyes on the ground. He's coming in. Grab him and hold him. Didn't grab him. He came in on the underneath and scooped.
Mac and cheese. Every November, the family is going crazy. I kill it every year. Now, you see, the secret of this mac and cheese is you have to bake your charge extra for water.
Pat.
Paper, plastic. How about plastic?
Pat.
So all you got is a wrench. Go hit me with a draw for
pat.
Jump in the boogie. So I can't get a second bowl.
Pat.
Sweet grits.
Pap, savory.
Let's talk about this junk mail.
Pap.
I keep getting
bitch.
Holy cakes. Ooh, that is sweet. Honey, ooh. What's that above? Oh, that's that Betty Crocker Duncan Hines. Come on. Holy cakes. Oh, what in the haberdashery and hemoglobin is going on? You just trolling it. This dog is getting walked by two different individuals. Why his legs look like he got honey glazed at 375, but his feet look like they throwing out the same raw.
Hey, y'all gotta watch this dog shit for you. Who's that, your mom? Three speed or corner.
An 82.
They been talking about Jimmy. This motherfucker here, dog. Niggas, bro. Niggas really be trying, bro.
Sunday, yeah. I'm here.
top. Bro, it's been toxic.
You're always fussing with people traffic.
Julio got double me. Bro, they really got this, man. The Dolphins got what the fuck? Yo. Hey, somebody been doing computer tricks, dog. Who the fuck text this guy? Somebody doing computer tricks, bro. Nah. Somebody did computer trade, bro. Come on, bro. Like, that don't make sense. You ain't getting nobody. We getting them 7th pick from Miami?
Yeah.
That's stupid, bro. Oh, yeah. Thank you. Jesus.
Right, mine either.
Cincinnati crowd in full effect a moment ago as their Bengals took the field to the
right. I'm good. How you doing? So they're all set as they'll match up with the Jacksonville Jaguars. I'm good. Oh, I'm good.
Right.
Touchback, and they will begin things at the 25. You could tell that he was going to run a long way, and that was pretty impressive. Completing it to the right side,
bro.
That catch good for only a couple.
Partners, a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything.
Bro, come on, bro. Hey, he's threatening you. D. That's why you dead 6'3" boyfriend be a beast. That's why.
To the 32-yard line. So far this season, this defense has had their issues against the pass, so that's a great sign for them to get the early pick.
Yeah, confidence builder for them and an absolute shock for the quarterback because he went into it. He saw the numbers we saw. He watched them on tape. I think he came into this one thinking this is going to be a big day.
My boy about to break, boy.
Some good hard running there as he'll push his way forward for about 5. We should mention, to go along with a great game he had last week, he was rightfully named AFC Offensive Player of the Week.
and he shares that with his offensive line, the tight end, his fullback. He's looking for more and more of that in this game.
Bro, how the fuck you can free? Let's go. Let's go. Let's go, baby. Let's freaking go. We're running the ball down people's throats, bro. Let's go.
To the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 to score as they start first and 10. He'll find Metcalf. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
It's a gain of 9.
Up at the 29 now, they'll head to the line. 2nd and a yard. He'll let this one go deep for Chark. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. 33 yards that time.
You know I'm going to lean towards the defender, right? You know I'm going to do that.
I know.
That's a tough situation for him as I see it. But the truth of the matter is, that ball was not streaking towards him. That little arm got it. He's got to find a way to get his head around and make a play on the football.
And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. Call that a very strong gain of 24. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete. Eli Apple, good to the core there as he gets in and knocks it away. So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on first down. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off with great anticipation. And now they bring it back. It's a pick six for Bengals TD. And this defense looking like they have come to play the pick six. And just like that, it's 13-0 early on.
Well, go back with me to our training camp visit. What do we hear during these drills? Pass. Ball's in the air.
And then my favorite.
Oski. That's the interception. That means everybody find someone to block. Block them legally. Stay on your feet. And they get it done. Touchdown.
Fielded near the back of the end zone. And they'll bring it out to the 25 as Agnew elects for the touchback.
25-yard line.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. Good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last that didn't bother you too much last time.
Nope.
And here's another interception, the third of this first quarter.
That ain't ready for us.
Picked off at the 21. And bring it back. It's a pick six for Bengals TD.
That was a nice catch, and not by the guy you thought it was going to be. How about the defender turning into an offensive player as soon as the ball hits his hands? And off he goes, off to the races, and into the end zone.
Extra point by Seibert, up and good. And that pushes the lead up to an even 20. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. By rule, that comes out to the 40-yard line. So good opportunity for this offense with solid field position. On first down, he'll drop to throw. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. He's picked off at his own 47. We haven't even escaped.
the first half, and he's already thrown four picks.
And Brandon, back in the good old days, probably back before you were born, if your starter threw four in the first half, he might throw eight or more for the game because they weren't going to pull him out. But nowadays, the patience level isn't quite there. He's going to have to make some real adjustments, or the backup may see some time.
Eluding the pressure right. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Josh Allen, credit him with a sack, and it goes as a loss of six. Now Joe Burrow on third and long. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Josh Allen able to record his fifth sack of the season.
And that's the first sack of this game, but how about last week? Six sacks, great coverage downfield, which helped that pass rush. They are really working in sync right now.
A nice return there of 11 to help mitigate a good punt. And the Jaguars go on offense, first down and 10. They'll start with the option. And he almost gets this to the 30, taken down about a yard shy.
Oh, yeah, good job.
Solid way to start the drive, 13 yards, picking up the first. Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. And he works his way forward for a couple up past the 30.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
An entertaining start to this one. More to come on EA Sports. Drop to throw. This is Johnson. He's got it. And he will have a Jaguars first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Rookie to rookie on the hookup there, and it's a first down. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And his throw is incomplete. DJ Chark, first-time Pro Bowler, the intended receiver. And now it's second down. Goodness, another interception. Picked off near the 29. And they will take over at the 29-yard line.
Oh, yeah.
And you have to wonder, Charles, a game like this, five interceptions, what does this do to the psyche of a young quarterback?
Well, based on the fact that he's still out there and he threw a fifth interception, I'm wondering if his head coach believes that he's really strong mentally and wants him to play through it. Because otherwise, you need to get him out and fight another day, because this could leave lasting damage if he keeps throwing interceptions.
First and 10 at the 43-yard line.
Mixon with a first down carry. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
And that's what I'd like to see out of this defense. A little fire, a little toughness. It hasn't been the best first half for them, but they did do a nice job there, forcing a loss on that play.
On second down, here's Mixon. And this looks a lot like the last play. Behind the line of scrimmage, he's tackled for the second straight go-around. Great job by this Jacksonville D. Just a loss of a yard there, but it's not going to help. Now they face a third and 14. From the gun on third down is Burrow. He finds his running back, Mixon, and he'll take this to the 47, but no further as they get him down well short of the line to gain. Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Fourth and goal, and down by a touchdown, the offense stays on the field. For it, Burrow. And this is caught, but they say out of bounds. That would have been a first down, but he couldn't stay in, and as a result, they're going to have to give up the football. So shall we say a bold decision to go for it, and that bold decision does not pay off.
And when you talk about bold, you're saying off
caps.
All caps.
Yeah, without a doubt. Maybe they're telling their defense they have a lot of faith in them. I mean, that's how you have to spin it, is that you tell your defense, you know something? We were able to go for it there because you guys are so good. I'm not worried about things. That's the only explanation I can come up with in this situation.
Well, he better get ready to spin it for that post-game presser because you know he's going to be out.
He's going to have to spin it for his own locker room, frankly.
Ricardo Allen, the safety, makes the stop. Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run.
Whenever we talk about the best strong safeties, one word constantly comes up, and that's instincts. Being able to diagnose run or pass and make the appropriate moves.
He crashed down hard there. He was ready for that running play. That's incomplete. Nearly another pick. My goodness. And now here is another interception. Picked off by Von Bell. And a very good return as he takes us all the way up to the 35-yard line. The Bengals drive about to get going. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on fourth, turned it over in their own territory. But the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it. Not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold
up. But he trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much. And I think that that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it. Be aggressive because I've got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
Well, we'll see what his offense can do. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Give him 17 and a Cincinnati first down. So in Jacksonville territory now. Here's a first and 10 at the 36. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
And he will go down outside of the pocket for a sack. Tried to get away, but could not. Play three of the drive, not as successful. They go backwards after those two first down gains. They'll come up after the sack on a second and 12. From the shotgun, it's Burrow. Throwing left side, it's complete. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. Got an open man. That's C.J. Uzama. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
Brings up second and five at the Jaguars' 10-yard line.
Burrow going to fake to mix it and now look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
Flush to his right. This will be caught at about the six. And the Bengals are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. It's a gain of six as they're able to convert, and now it's first and goal. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
And that is caught. He's got it for a Bengal touchdown. From 4 yards out, and the Bengals add on to their lead.
They have really had their way so far in the first half, but they wanted to continue to build on their lead. They know that no lead is safe in this league, so they decided to try their best to get one more as they headed into the half, and they got it done.
Austin Seibert set to kick off.
Following the touchdown, here's Seibert now to kick it off. And
This carries into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 25 as Agnew elects for the touchback. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try? And my goodness, another interception.
Let's do on plans. He's not good, bro. Yo. You don't believe what scores.
Out of the gun, it's Burrow. He'll find his running back, Joe Mixon.
Who is?
And he's gonna get this inside the 30. The Bengals gonna use the second of the
TSU.
As they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half.
That's a dope. Tofu.
First down, here's Burrow. Gonna throw right side here, complete. Now the Bengals gonna signal for their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. On first and 10, Joe Burrow. And he's got a touchdown.
That guy's due 31 to zip in the second quarter. And this is a commission.
This taken in about 4 yards deep. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. Now the ball banked way up, so thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation.
I think he think my cornerbacks are slow, and my cornerback, dog, the Bengals cornerbacks is not slow. He think my cornerbacks slow. They're not. Like, oh, I pressed the wrong. I think I had a touchdown. He done him? Yeah, I'm hoping this dude has 34 is zero.
The Bengals set to receive. They have the lead and the football to begin quarter number three. Taken about 7 yards deep. They had the half. The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. He's able to rattle off six on the carry, and that'll get him to third and four.
Makes it third and four.
From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. Flood. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Josh Allen in there to get him, and that is sack number six now for him on the year.
To me, the defense was looking a little gassed near the end of the first half, but they've come out of the locker room with a little extra spring in their step. Wonder what they did at halftime to get them so motivated.
I don't know, but that sack looked good. Now let's see if they can build on the momentum of that play. And he'll go out of bounds, it looks like, right at the 40. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Oh, he finds his running back who snuck right down the middle of the field. And they're going to have this way down in Cincinnati territory. And I think that's a pretty good illustration of why they try to get the football into his hands out of the backfield. That was something else. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10. And it's intercepted at the goal line. picked up by Jesse Bates. And the return will stop him well inside their own 20 at the 15-yard line. Those INTs all sting, but you throw one in the red zone, I think especially as a rookie, maybe it stings a little bit more.
I think what you're saying is they don't all count the same, do they? Right? Interceptions in the red zone that you've given up points now, those are precious, so you have to learn from those and in a hurry.
And a hard-earned yard there as he ran through one would-be tackler. It's second down.
17-yard line. A gain of a yard. Brings up second and nine.
The quick throw by Burrow is complete. Powering his way forward. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. A gain of 28 yards there and give him a first down. On first down, Mixon. And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
And 11 at the 44 yard line.
Second and 11. They'll stay on the ground. Mixon again. 4 yards on the pickup there as they get it back to a more manageable third and 7.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Mixon with a first down and more. And he is going to have a Bengals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. Over the middle, it's complete. And they'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. Too far downfield, something those linemen have to watch out for, and that time it costs them. Throw it with Burrow. He gets this in the hands of Mixon. Nothing at all on that one. It'll be second down.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Burrow going to give this to Mixon. They're going to snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down. Again, it's Mixon. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. 2 yards on the pickup there. It's fourth down. Nice job there on the tackle. Keep him to the short gain. And, of course, he got some good news this week. He was named AFC Defensive Player of the Week from last week's effort.
And part of the reason he got that award, because of plays like that. Not every play is spectacular. Not every play is for a loss. Make the plays that are in front of you. Keep it to short gains, and you pile up statistics.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not a...
Taking it right down Broadway. 20, 10. And they're going to have this way down in Cincinnati territory.
This is our time.
A big play there on the catch and run. 89 yards. Well, that didn't take long. One play, and we're already looking at a first and goal situation. Back now in Cincinnati. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair. Johnson with a completion over the middle. And he will get this into the end zone for a Jaguar touchdown. Colin Johnson. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Jags take advantage of field position on the turnover to cash this one in. Point after by Lambeau, up and good. And the lead drops from 34 down to 27.
And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The Bengals drive about to get going. The outcome of this one, well, we know who's going to win it. It's just all window dressing at this point. Got me thinking, what's the biggest blowout that you've been a part of as a player, broadcaster?
No, I'm not going to go to the player part because when I think blowout...
Because you won every game as a player.
No. I think about being blown out. And no one wants to go back to those memories. But, you know, when I was calling college football, I saw a game that, you know, a team put 70. I actually saw it happen twice. A team put 70 on their opponent. And in the NFL in the 2017 season, I saw one of those changing of the guard games where a team that hadn't been very good before now was dominating and kicking around a team who had been ruling their division.
And that's when you earn your paycheck, right? As the analyst, you got to fill that time.
You've got to know what's going on out there and how it all happened.
Well, obviously, that begs the question. What game was it?
That was Seattle hosting Los Angeles, the Rams.
Ah, yeah.
Their second meeting of the season, and the Rams turned it around from the first.
And it's a fake here on fourth and inches. And the gamble pays off. They get the first. Anxious moments there on the fake, but they do get just enough to pick up the first down. Now Joe Mixon. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three.
The tackle made by Rayshon Jenkins.
Again, it's Mixon. And some space here. And he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown. Joe Mixon with touchdown number 7 on the year as his guys continue to pour it on. So there, Charles, I mean, a situation where it didn't matter how far he had to run, he was not going to be denied, and he winds up taking this all the way to the end zone. And this one was over a while ago as they just hang on to their big lead. Following the kickoff. Fielded near the back of the end zone. 30. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30, up to the 33. Their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be
hoping for this drive when you start thinking.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked up by Jesse Bates. The utter domination here just continues. This defense, I don't know what more we can say all around about their performance.
Well, it certainly feels in this game like maybe they're facing a Canadian defense. 12 guys on the field. It feels like there's an extra on every snap because they have really struggled to make headway through the air.
And I think he's going to go. They're not going to get him.
You don't like this.
And all the way in for a Cincinnati score.
There you go. Got him again.
Joe Mixon, his second touchdown of the afternoon as his guys continue to put this one out of reach. They seemingly just continue to score at will. And as great as it's been for the offense, you got to feel for that defense down there.
Yeah, I love that you use the word will, because both teams came into the game with the will to win, but one team has obviously imposed its will on the other and broken them. Because what we're seeing right now, wow, that's a defense that's in tatters after what they faced in this ball game.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh. Johnson, oh, it's poke free. Football's out. And the Bengals grab it. And they are going to take possession of the football inside the 15 at the 14-yard line. There's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. They'll run on first down. Mixon, and maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. And it's intercepted at the goal line.
picked off by Sidney Jones. And a big turnover as his guys will get the football back.
They'll take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. That one complete. He finds Sharp. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down.
A gain of 18 on the play. First down, Jaguar.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. And 26 big yards on that one. It's another first down.
Jaguar, first down.
They'll look to throw here on first down. And now here is another interception. Picked off around the 27. And he's able to get it back to the 33-yard line. Coming up on the final 2.5 minutes. And boy, has it been fun to watch this offense operate. Quite the display. And now they look to polish it off. Not much there. Maybe a couple up to the 35.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. Looks like he'll throw here. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 10 more there and another first down.
First and 10 at the 18.
Now whistles and a flag. And I believe a Bengal got going a little early there. It's a loss of 5 there. Bringing up second. Burrow will throw. Looking middle and that's complete. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. Another first down as they call his number again. He's got 15 yards here.
7-yard line.
And Burrow going to throw again. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
They'll take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And he'll be taken down by the Bengal pressure. And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. And he's going to be taken down. Sacked back at the 2. Sam Hubbard making his presence felt in the backfield. Facing the prospect of a punt from their own end zone, they need some cushion. Let's see what they can do on third down. Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for Cincinnati, it'll be a 500 start as the win gets them back to 2-2. And they'll hit the road next week to take on the Baltimore Ravens. Meanwhile, for the Jaguars, they also will exit this one at 2-2. And they'll look to regroup next week as they head to Houston to take on the Texans. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew here at EA Sports, I'm Brandon Gauden saying so long, everybody.
For the wins, came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. Yeah. I got it right in the end. Hey. Now we on top once again. I don't want it if it ain't love.
if it ain't get it away from me. Who you gon' jack if it ain't us? Take me to the bakery. Some mad that I came up. I know my granny gon' pray for me. It was just us in the vacancy. We had to get it from A to B. Wheels never felt like this. Two seats in the hills, how feel righteous. Blue sheets with the mills, but the deal priceless. New keys can't care what's still private. I might just double it up. Did it. Never enough, I'm with it. 5-2-3 on the business. Whole team got wins in the world suspended. I told them what I told them. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. Hey, I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top. Got a spot and it's locked to the click all in. I got ops, if he drop, I just hit my dance. I was pop, they just watched, had to take my wins. They wouldn't let me in, I've been on 10-10 since. Who really holding it down, I've been holding it down and I go to the can and again. Who is the dummy that died, I'm the coldest of gravity, falling again and again. I'm in the day, I'm doing 30 on 30 and up. You in the what? You in the way. Either you rolling the dust, you win it, so what?
Keep it running.
We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top, top once again. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on 10, 10, 10.
shoot back at me.
Hey, boy, and be something. You gotta go berserk.
Okay. Sometimes you need a friend, not the ones that just show up and don't put nothing in. You know the ones that lend a hand and want to see you win. When you come up on that lick, make sure you cut them in. And then, sometimes you need a foe, one to keep your eyes open, keep you on your toes. You know the ones that want to keep you where you've been before. But I can't go, no, I can't go. And whoa, sometimes I need a check.